Today I want to talk about a monitor that has been in my kit for over a year and has really helped me produce some of the best images to date. I'm talking about the Osee T7 monitor from Osee Tech, and here are some of the reasons I fell in love with this monitor and have taken it on almost all of my shoots. The Osee T7 comes with a huge 7-inch display, and coming from the usual 5-inch displays from much smaller monitors, I was a bit skeptical about lugging around a monitor this big. Screen resolution for this monitor is at 1920 by 1200, so you are really getting some nice images on the display. After using this monitor for a while, it is really hard to go back to anything smaller. Because of the large display, I am able to really nail focus without straining my eyes, and the extra real estate has me paying a lot of attention to my framing and composition and being careful with the details. If you are worried about the weight, I didn't find it as heavy as I thought it would be, as it is made of a polycarbonate material instead of an all-metal casing. However, it does feel durable. One of the biggest features of this monitor and what had caught my attention is the 3000 nits of brightness. I literally could shoot in broad daylight and see everything on this screen without a sunhood. Disclaimer: I did work out a request for a sunhood in exchange for an honest review of the monitor, however, it is not needed and I usually slap it on when I want to minimize some reflections on the screen. You have all the bells and whistles you need as a filmmaker to monitor your image, such as false color, to monitor your exposure settings. Focus assist is also included with a black and white function, along with the built-in 3D LUTs and D-Log LUTs to convert a variety of log files to Rec. 709. You do have the option to add your own LUTs via an SD card slot. Waveforms, histograms, vector scopes, and audio level monitoring comes as a standard. I love that you can create 8 scenes and add up to 8 tools per scene for easy access while navigating via a joystick with a click to select. While some may argue that touchscreen is the way to go and should even be standard at this point, I actually prefer the joystick as it prevents fingerprint smearing on the screen, which could hinder your monitoring. Although the joystick is a plastic feel, I did not have a hard time navigating the menu and tools after a few tries, so it does get intuitive. I think if you are in the market for a new monitor, the Osee T7 has great value, coming in at $427 US at the time of this review. While it isn't the most compact monitor, the extra real estate space is kind to the eyes, and the T7 operates a lot better than other monitors in the market. For me, outside of the standard shipping monitoring tools that come along with the T7, the biggest sell at this price point is the brightness coming in at 3000 nits. I can tell you, living on a tropical island with blaring hot sun, this monitor does not disappoint. I've used this monitor in some extreme conditions and it has survived my first year with it. I am definitely happy with this investment, and I find this monitor attached to my camera 95% of the time I am shooting a project. For more details regarding specs and features of the Osee T7 monitor, check out the link below in the description. And if you found this review helpful, please like and subscribe. Thank you.